Thank you all for coming this afternoon. It's a great honor to have this opportunity to engage with you. Here at the U.S. Embassy, we work every day on the U.S.-Algeria bilateral relationship, strengthening economic partnerships, deepening cultural ties, especially in English language learning, and promoting peace and stability in the region. And so as the ambassador, my top priority is to continue to grow our robust economic relationship. You know, the U.S. and Algeria have a strong and growing relationship with more than 100 U.S. companies doing business here in Algeria. We have $3.2 billion this year, and we're still in November, in two-way trade between our two countries. And the United States is the top foreign direct investor in stock foreign direct investment, with 28% of all foreign direct investment, that's $6.2 billion, coming from the United States into Algeria. And you know, with all of those numbers, during my mandate here, I'd like to double them. I'd like to increase all of those relationships. Algeria is a resource-rich country. The most important resource that you have are your people. And I have seen that getting to visit across Algeria, the absolute incredible diversity, resilience, and brilliance of Algerians, polyglot, educated, just a fantastic population. And through our educational and cultural programs, we're supporting Algeria's efforts to improve and expand on English language and English language learning. We're excited that this is a way where we can offer resources and training that will, that's something that Algeria wants and that will help prepare Algeria's workforce for the future. We work with the Ministry of Culture and Arts to preserve Algeria's rich cultural heritage. We have about $1 million in projects that we're working on right now. And I recently got to go to Batna and see the Madrasan. We're working on a study project to see if that site can be restored. And you know, a direct flight from Algiers to the United States would go a long way in both expanding our economic relationship, but also our people-to-people ties and cultural exchanges. So I'm very hopeful for a direct flight during my time here. You know, of course, the United States and Algeria work on security cooperation, and we share a concern about terrorism and extremism. That will continue to be a cornerstone in our bilateral relationship as we seek stability and prosperity in North Africa and the Sahel. And so, it's been so exciting to be back here. This is my second time in Algeria. I was the number two here at the embassy from 2011 to 2014. And so to be able to come back and have the Secretary of State visit very early during my tenure, to have One Beat Sahara, the biggest musical festival ever outside of the United States, the first one in Africa held in Algeria, where Algerian and American musicians, along with Algeria's, each of Algeria's neighbors getting to contribute. Being the country of honor at the Algiers International Fair, a lot of really wonderful things have happened during this part of my second time in Algeria, and I have seen firsthand how rich and multifaceted our relationship is, and I look forward to answering any questions you might have about that today. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon, Victoria Excellency. This is Rajab Ben Ahmed from NRTV Channel. I want first of all to congratulate you for your post here, on your post here as the ambassador. I have a couple of questions. First of all, speaking of collaboration between Algeria and USA, there is plenty of projects that Algerians are waiting to achieve, such as the direct flight between Algeria and the United States, and also maybe a cultural institute to have, like the Algerians have the ability to learn English. How far this project or the progress on these projects so far? And the second one, you have met several figures and also the president since during the last 10 months. And you have talked about many things, like about increasing the number of companies and investing more in Algeria. And you said that you have to, or your mission is to double these numbers. Is there any project that like we're waiting for the next days? Thank you very much.
So you've asked a lot of questions. I'll try to manage that. Do you need to interpret before we, you're fine for? Okay, good. So I'll try to answer some of these. On an American cultural center, the United States has 5 American cultural centers in Algeria where you can go, anyone can go, and have English language conversations completely without charge, right? We don't charge for English language learning. And so we have centers in Oran, Algiers, Constantine, Ouargla, and we just received approval from the Algerian government to open our English language center in Bashar. And so I'm really thrilled that we have these opportunities and many more for English language learning. We do a program with the Algerian government called LINK, where we help Algerian government officials learn professional English so they can speak at international conferences and speak to interlocutors across the globe. We have a program called Access that provides 2 years of English language instruction to high school students. We have a variety of programs across the sphere of English language learning, and we're thrilled about that. The direct flight is something that's very exciting to me. It's a straight path to the United Nations from Algiers. I think it's a very wonderful idea that will take us to the next level in our economic relationship. And so we are in negotiations with the Algerian government right now on an open skies agreement that will then allow direct flights to be able to start. So I can't, unfortunately, talk about future things that haven't happened yet, but I certainly can give you 2 recent examples. There's a new partnership between a U.S. company and Algerian firm to build a private hospital in Blida that's going to have a paramedic school associated with it, and it will have a U.S. certification. So that's one exciting recent joint partnership. Another one is a shrimp farm in the Wilaya of Relizan, where a U.S. company and an Algerian company have joined together to create a commercial shrimp farm venture business so that shrimp will be sold all throughout Algeria. So those are 2 recent examples, and I'm very hopeful to see more like that in the future. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum. Good morning, Your Excellency. So I have questions about the law investment that Algeria has released lately. So are there any new investment in the near future here in Algeria between the United States and Algeria? Also, I have another question about the cooperation between Algeria and the United States about fighting terrorism, especially that you mentioned the Sahel and Africa and the safety of Africa.
On the questions of investments, so future investments aren't something that I can talk about until they're done. So I gave you 2 recent examples. I have conversations with Algerian companies and American companies every week. There are lots of plans in progress, and so I think we will continue to see good news like the 2 examples that I just gave you across the economic sphere, right? Algeria is diversifying its economy. The U.S. wants to be a part of that diversification. We can do that. We should be Algeria's partner of choice, and I'll tell you why. Because we share technology and we employ Algerians. In the halls of U.S. companies all across Algeria, there are Algerians who are running those companies. And they're using U.S. technology and U.S. know-how. And that's why we're a great partner for anyone looking to have foreign direct investment. And one more point on the economic issues and looking for U.S. partners. The Foreign Commercial Service has a direct portal, internet portal, where Algerian companies can go directly to look for U.S. partners. and to make their interest known. And so through our embassy website, you can find that that portal. On the question of security cooperation, the United States and Algeria have strategic dialogue processes, both political dialogue and military dialogue, to discuss regional issues. Algeria and the U.S. share a desire for regional stability and prosperity across the Sahel and across the Maghreb. We consult with Algeria frequently on issues in the region and seek their input and guidance on many, many files that we are concerned about. Certainly, extremism in the Sahel is a big concern, and we work closely with our partners in the region, including Algeria, in addressing those difficult issues.
Ne pas brûler sa relation avec l'Algérie, qui est considérée comme un partenaire stratégique et important. Entre les deux, comment est perçue concrètement l'Algérie dans l'administration américaine actuelle, entre ces deux avis-là?
Thank you for that question. I think it's a very important issue to discuss. There are, and to put into context, right, there are three separate but equal branches of government in the United States. And those branches communicate with each other and discuss policy with each other, both privately and publicly. And so one senator and 27 members of Congress have signed letters to, as a part of the legislative branch, to the executive branch to start this discussion. It's important to understand there are 535 members of Congress. So 27 plus 1 out of 535 have asked that a discussion be started. So that's how the United States, that's often how our government speaks to each other. And that's often how conversations get started. It is true that weapons procurement is a concern to the United States government. It is also true that Algeria is a strategic partner and an important partner to the United States. And so all of this will be weighed by policymakers over the coming weeks and months. I would like to add that any partner nation engaging in or considering transactions with Russia's defense sector are strongly and consistently urged to consider diversification of their defense procurement. And we have heard Algerian officials, Algerian authorities, state their intent to diversify weapons, defense stocks, weapon stocks, and increase purchases from non-Russian partners.
Fouzia Faris, a journalist of APS. Congratulations for your new post.
Thank you.
I will ask my question in Arabic.
كيف تنظر الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية إلى مخرجات القمة العربية التي احتضنتها الجزائر مؤخرا؟ وكيف تنظر أيضا إلى إعلان الجزائر الذي جمعت بين الفصائل الفلسطينية على أرض الجزائر؟
Algeria held a very successful Arab League summit, and it was very exciting, actually, because for the first time in the history of Arab League summits, the United States was invited to be an observer. And so I was able to attend the Arab League summit, and that was an historic occasion for the United States. We had an opportunity, of course, to speak with many Arab partner nations and have conversations across the region right here in Algiers, as well as, of course, to have conversations with Algerian officials. On the Palestinian faction issue, we applaud Algeria's desire for peace and for bringing together disparate groups in unity. We think that's a great thing that Algeria is trying to do, and we applaud that. And the one thing I'd like to add to that is both Algeria and the United States desire a two-state solution. This is a necessary step to get us down the road to those negotiations. Thank you.
اهلا شكرا سعاده السفير علي العكون قناه البلاد. اول شيء اود نرجع لقضيه سؤال حول 27 عضو في الكونغرس. طبعا السيده السفيره قالت انه هذا جزء من الكونغرس فقط في هذا النقاش، لكن ما يبدو انه في الساحه الامريكيه هناك مزايدات حزبيه خصوصا في الانتخابات النصفيه وقادمه الانتخابات الرئاسيه الامريكيه بين الحزبين الجمهوري والديمقراطي. هذا ممكن انه يزيد من هذا التطرف والمزايدات بين الحزبين، وهذا ممكن انه ياثر حتى على المشاريع وتطوير العلاقات كما ذكرتيه في مداخلتك سعاده السفيره. ثانيا حول قضيه موقف الاداره الامريكيه من قضيه الصحراء الغربيه، حتى الان لا يوجد موقف واضح جدا. هل الاداره الامريكيه حاليا اداره بايدن متمسكه بقرار ترامب بالاعتراف بسياده المغرب على اقليم الصحراء الغربيه؟ من جهة لم يكن هناك تراجع واضح، من جهة أخرى نسمع أصوات تقول أنها تريد حل في إطار الشرعية الدولية وهو يقتضي تقرير المصير. كما نسأل أيضا حول أن العديد من الأصوات المغربية كل سنة تدعو وتقول أن مناورات الأسد الإفريقي تجري في التراب الصحراء الغربية، وبالتالي أنه هذا قرار واضح وعملي من واشنطن بسيادة المغرب على الصحراء الغربية. نريد توضيحات. شكرا.
Okay, we'll start with the first issue. I didn't say only 27 members of Congress, I said 27, not only. Okay, 27, 27 are important, but it's important and appropriate to understand the context. Out of 535, there are 27 who have raised this issue publicly, right? We don't necessarily, sitting in Algiers, know all of the private conversations that are happening. Those are the public. Those are the letters that members of Congress chose to make public. Clearly, I can't speculate on the future, but what I can tell you is that we continue to encourage diversification of defense procurement, and we see Algeria as an important and strategic partner. On the issue of Western Sahara, we have a clear policy, and we share that policy imperative with Algeria. We share a desire for a UN negotiated process where Stéphane de Mistura, the personal envoy of the special Secretary General, has the opportunity and has space to talk to the various parties involved to come to an acceptable solution. 47 years is a long time to not have a definite path forward. And so we completely and full-throatedly support Stéphane de Mistura in his efforts. As we have heard from the Algerian authorities, they do as well. On the issue of African lion exercises, I'll refer any specific questions you have about African lion to the Department of Defense. What I will say is that African Lion is run by AFRICOM and was not in any territory that is disputed. It's important to know that there are names of cities and names of wilayas that are the same but are different places. And so it's important to understand what one is actually talking about geographically. African Lion was not held in any disputed area. It was held in Morocco and was with, the United States is friends with Morocco, as we are friends with Algeria, and it was held in friendly terms in a neighboring country. Thank you.
Merci. Oui, c'était déjà l'indépendant. Moi, je vais revenir sur le volet économique. Il y a eu plusieurs visites d'hommes d'affaires de délégations américaines en Algérie, notamment après la publication de la nouvelle loi sur l'investissement. Quels sont les secteurs prioritaires pour les hommes d'affaires américains pour investir ici en Algérie, ou bien quels sont les secteurs qui les intéressent le plus? Et aussi, qu'en est-il de la coopération dans le domaine des énergies renouvelables? Voilà. Merci.
Not only have there been trade delegations from the US to Algeria, but there have also been trade delegations from Algeria to the US. and it's across the entire economic sphere. Pharmaceuticals, healthcare, information technology, renewables, water, how to manage droughts and other water issues. There's just been a whole host of exchanges back and forth between US companies and Algerian companies seeking potential partnerships. And that's in many, many sectors outside of traditional oil and gas. And it's exciting to see all of these exchanges happen because it shows the great interest in diversifying Algeria's economy and the fact that the US wants to be a part of that. We believe in win-win partnerships, and that's what we find here in Algeria. There's vast potential. There's an enormous market here. There's enormous interest, and we're here to be partners in that. And if I can just add one more thing, I'm actually planning to take a delegation myself of Algerian companies to the Disaster Resilience Expo in Miami, Florida next March, exactly because we are here to provide solutions in all sectors of the economy, and that includes fighting forest fires, dealing with floods, earthquake preparation and recovery, all the kinds of issues that we are all facing. You know, the United States and Algeria are a lot alike. We're experiencing drought in the western part of the United States. We're experiencing floods that suddenly come, sometimes as a result of the drought. And so working on those issues is very important to us, and we plan to take a delegation of Algerian companies to the US to look at those kinds of solutions as well. Thank you.
Bonsoir, Thierry Mauguet du journal Mujahid. Alors, félicitations pour votre poste, madame. Plein succès pour votre mission d'ambassadrice en Algérie, que vous menez si bien d'ailleurs, ma montée. Vous êtes très présente, très présente sur le terrain, donc vous avez effectué plusieurs visites. Maintenant, pour les questions, d'abord les questions économiques. Il me semble que lors de la dernière fois commerciale, les États-Unis ont été l'invité d'honneur de l'événement. Donc, vous avez évoqué avec le président de la République l'organisation d'un forum algéro-américain. Donc, on est avec la préparation de ce forum d'affaires algéro-américain. Sinon, ce serait aussi intéressant de connaître votre avis sur les réformes politiques, économiques, qui a engagé l'Algérie depuis l'élection du président de la République. Donc, il y a toute une dynamique de changement, il y a de nouvelles lois, notamment le code d'investissement. Donc, ça serait bien de connaître votre avis, votre appréciation de cette dynamique de réforme. Vous avez évoqué tout à l'heure que le sommet arabe a été un succès retentissant, un grand succès pour prendre. Donc, le sommet arabe a été quand même le résultat d'un effort diplomatique, d'un travail diplomatique très soutenu. Là aussi, c'est également, je vous demande votre appréciation sur le redéploiement de la diplomatie algérienne au plan régional et international, et par extension, je vous demande aussi votre avis sur le processus engagé de l'adhésion de l'Algérie au BRICS, donc comment vous percevez ça, ainsi que sur vous avez de la concurrence en matière de coopération, ainsi que sur la signature de deuxième accord stratégique quinquennal avec la Chine. Je passe maintenant à l'événement planétaire du moment, donc la Coupe du Monde. C'est la Coupe du Monde. L'événement s'organise pour la première fois dans un pays arabe. On a vu quand même des responsables de l'événement qui ont dénoncé, entre guillemets, ce qu'ils appellent, notamment le président de la FIFA, qui a parlé d'hypocrisie occidentale, vu toutes les campagnes pour tenter d'hypothéquer cet événement. On aimerait avoir là aussi un petit commentaire. Dernière question, madame, si vous permettez. Donc, la place des médias dans la coopération algéro-américaine. Merci.
Okay. I'm going to try. We'll see how far we get. I may need help with the last one. Okay, on the Arab League, these are not easy events to put together. And Algeria, from where I sit, not being a member of the Arab League, and again, it was the first time the United States even was able to observe Arab League summit happenings. So this was all wonderful and different, but we saw Algeria going out and making the kind of diplomatic entrees and speaking, creating ties, speaking with other countries in the Arab League. You know, it seemed like quite an amazing set of events to bring together everyone here in Algiers, and I think that the results speak loudly for Algeria's regional leadership and their desire to create peace and stability in the region. And if you allow me, rather than talking about Algerian participation in other economic fora, I'll reiterate why the United States should be a partner of choice. Why should U.S. companies be a partner of choice? So we don't come with plane loads of executives. We don't come with plane loads of workers. We work with Algerian counterparts to create value added, to build partnerships, to share know-how, and we hire Algerians in the process. And I think that's a really important thing that makes the United States and U.S. companies distinct and attractive to any country and any company that's trying to develop, because we are very unique in that way. You asked a question about COP, I think, in Egypt? BRICS? No. BRICS in China, I just answered. I said I'm not going to talk about that, right? What I'm going to talk about is U.S. companies and what we have to offer. I'm not going to talk about other partnerships. That's not my, right? That's not my domain. My domain is talking about the U.S. and what we have to offer. If you heard my speech at the trade fair in June, I said there were three things that U.S. companies value in a partnership in working in an overseas environment. And that is a stable regulatory framework. That is not needing to have import restrictions. In other words, we live in a global economy, having the free flow of goods in and out of a country, and having the free flow of profits in and out of a country. Those are three things the U.S. is looking for. U.S. companies are looking for in a market. That's super important. There are other things as well, but those are three. If you're talking about law and regulatory frameworks, those are sort of three things that matter a lot to U.S. companies. And this investment law that Algeria recently put into place answers many of those issues, and I think it's a great step forward.
Okay. مروان والناس من إذاعة الجزائر الدولية. السؤال الأول: من إفرازات الحرب الأوكرانية الروسية هي أزمة الطاقة في العالم، هل الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية تراهن على دور الجزائر في المساعدة في التخفيف على من أزمة الطاقة في الأسواق العالمية؟ السؤال الأول. السؤال الثاني يتعلق بمنطقة الساحل والصحراء. هناك اضطرابات سياسية وانقلابات عسكرية في الكثير من دول هذه المنطقة، وهناك تراجع للنفوذ الفرنسي، وفرنسا هي حليف للولايات المتحدة في المنطقة. في المقابل هناك تمدد روسي، روسيا تدخل في المنطقة، هناك قوة فاغنر في مالي. هل هذه التطورات تقلق الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية؟ السؤال الأخير: هل ستشاهدين مباراة إيران والولايات المتحدة الأمريكية؟ وما هي توقعاتك؟ وما هو رأيك في حفل افتتاح مونديال قطر؟ وشكرا جزيلا.
So on Qatar, let me just say that may the best team win. I wish Algeria was there because I'd be rooting for them. On COP, look, we have a planet that needs help, and we're all in on helping the planet. And if we can see methane flaring reduction across the planet, that's going to help all of us. On the energy crisis, you're right. The war in Ukraine has caused an energy crisis. It was completely unnecessary. And millions of people are being infected not only by the energy crisis, but by food insecurity because of Russia's aggression in Ukraine. That needs to be very clear. It did not need to happen. Algeria can be very helpful with the energy crisis. Algeria has oil and gas that can be very useful. And Algeria has been playing a very helpful role in creating partnerships and working with other countries in Europe that they perhaps have worked with before and or are increasing those partnerships to help with the energy situation in Europe. It's going to be a long winter. On the Sahel, exactly because of the instability you describe, are reasons why the U.S. and Algeria both want to partner, to work together, to mitigate, to create economic opportunities, to create political stability, to increase prosperity among the countries of the Sahel, so that we don't see the kind of extremism and the kind of mercenaries and mercenary groups that are currently operating there. We would like to see a situation where Sahelian countries have the ability to govern in their space and to create societies where people can work and earn a living and take care of their families. It's what we all want, right, in all countries. And so the United States and Algeria will keep working on that situation with a view to giving the countries in question across the Sahel needed help in whatever form they request. In terms of World Cup football games, I wish I had the time to see as many football games as I possibly could. Of course, as the U.S. ambassador to Algeria, I'm often working on the U.S.-Algeria relationship. But if I get the chance, I'll watch any of the World Cup games. And of course, since Algeria is not there, we'll be, rooting for the USA, of course.
Merci beaucoup.